They're the largely unsung stars behind some of our nation's most important projects. But one night every year, they stand center stage. With Kris Van Cleave, we're off to the Opal Awards, the Oscars of engineering.
Just after 6:30 this morning, the bridge collapsed.
Infrastructure is almost by design.
A blackout has...
Something we only seem to notice when something goes wrong.
Mississippi's capital lost its water supply several days ago when heavy rain altered the quality of its drinking water.
A lot of what we do is out of sight and out of mind.
Tom Smith, the executive director of the American Society of Civil Engineers, says the public rarely thinks about the untold number of engineering successes that make everyday life possible.
What happens when they flush their toilets? How does that clean water get to them in the morning so they can brush their teeth? People take it for granted when you flip the switch and the lights come on, all the engineering that goes into that. So we want to make sure that it is recognized and celebrated. And we think it deserves a red carpet.
You heard that right, a red carpet. Since 1960, ASCE has hosted the Opal Awards, an opulent gala where members trade in their slide rules for black tie and glitzy gowns.
And who are you wearing?
Oh, no idea.
I don't get many opportunities to wear this, so it's nice to get it out of the closet.
To celebrate what might be infrastructure's biggest night.
This is the Oscars of civil engineering.
ASC supports those who make big things. Big bridges? Yes. Big roads? Yes. Big water supply and treatment facilities? Yes.
Past winners include a lot of big things, like the St. Louis Arch, Boston's Big Dig, and New York City's Second Avenue Subway. The nominees this time included transportation projects, power and water plants, even the demolition of an oceanfront hotel in an environmentally sensitive part of Hawaii. But the top prize...
The winner is the Rainier Square redevelopment project.
Essentially, infrastructure's best picture went to Rainier Square, a blockbuster in the form of a Seattle skyscraper built using an innovative new construction technique called SpeedCore. It cut the construction time nearly in half.
Wow.
Saving millions.
Outstanding.
Were you surprised when you heard your name?
Stunned is probably the right word.
Ron Klemencic was Rainier Square's lead engineer. He's also SpeedCore's biggest cheerleader.
In terms my grandmother would understand, what is SpeedCore?
So SpeedCore is a prefabricated modular wall system. Think of Lego building blocks, and then we stack them up one on top of another, and then ultimately come back and fill them with concrete to make them strong enough and stiff enough.
Someone compared it to an ice cream sandwich.
Yeah, ice cream sandwich is a good analogy.
This would be the chocolate cookie part of
the
ice cream sandwich.
That is correct.
More than 17 years in the making, SpeedCore was developed as an open source technology that's free to utilize by a group of nonprofits and colleges, including Purdue University, where Amit Varma teaches engineering.
All you have to do is fill it with concrete and you're good to go.
With money from the recent bipartisan infrastructure bill starting to flow, there is a hope among the engineers in this room.
Tonight's totally inspirational.
That we're entering a new golden age of infrastructure.
I love civil engineering, truly. You guys rock.
And they seem honored to help build it.
Do you feel pressure to make sure that you have engineered an appropriately interesting, structurally speaking, statue?
Absolutely. So we take this very seriously.
Because I'll tell you, the Emmy statues have a tendency to break at their base.
Ours don't break.
Yeah.